Well, if you'll permit me to doodle over our grammar, one way to get started with this is to think about what's in chart 0. These two are in chart 0. T goes to dot BQR and T goes to dot BQS, and we haven't seen anything yet. So if we start from that in chart 0, the only operation we can do is to shift to get to chart position 1. Shift over the input P if that's actually the first character of the input. Well, it totally is. That's super convenient. So we're going to move these dots over here and get T goes to P dot QR and T goes to P dot QS from 0 in chart state 1. Oh. So both of the first two are correct. Now we're going to have dots in front of the Q. So we're going to bring in Q goes to dot Q from 1 in chart position 1. Now we're going to look at the input again and see that the next token is actually Q. So we're going to shift over this and put the result in chart 2. So in fact, this one's correct as well. Wow, we're on a roll. Now the last two involve doing reductions. We see Q goes to little q, and we've seen all the input we need by the time we're in chart state 2. 0, 1, 2. We've seen two characters of the input. So we're going to go back to states that had a dot in front of a big Q and say, we have found your big Q. We're done with it. So chart 1 had a dot in front of a big Q. We'll conceptually shift over it, and chart 2 will now have that dot after the big Q. And another way to interpret this is, after seeing two characters in the input, we could be here. Well, the first character is P, great, and the second character is little q, which we reduce up to big Q, so yeah, this is totally where we are, right? My finger is right there, starting from 0 with no more hidden tokens on the left. So in fact, both of these are also right. We will do the reduction and do this sort of pretend shifting for this first rule, and also for the second rule. In general, we do all the shifting, all the reductions, all the closures possible. Boy, it's a good thing we're going to have a computer program do this for us, because doing it by hand is starting to get long. This was a particularly tricky quiz, so don't feel bad if you missed a few of these. In the end, though, all of them were right.